this leads me to the next tool, which is Listing Builder. When you create a listing on Amazon, there's lots of different parts to it. So the first thing I want to show you is, like, here in the search results, this is the title of the listing. It's the very first thing that people ever see, along with a thumbnail. When we go into the listing itself, the title appears here. Then we have these bullet points. And whether you have a professional Amazon seller account or you've got the free version, everybody has access to these 5 bullet points. We call these features, and you definitely want to make sure to include highly relevant keywords both in your title and in your features itself. But even below that, when you're on a desktop computer and you scroll down past all the other ads that Amazon gives you, there's also this product description area where you can write some more information if you want to. If this seller has what's called brand registry, they have a trademarked brand and they've applied for brand registry with Amazon, Amazon will give them access to what we call A+ content. This seller does not seem to have that, but usually that A+ content is an extra section right here where you can put even more keywords. So I point all this out because the anatomy of a listing is actually a little bit complicated. And with our tool, you can create a really good quality listing that you know includes those relevant keywords, but we'll also give you information about, like, how many characters you've used and whether you've made use of all those bullet points. So here in my kind of lobby for the Listing Builder tool, we have a lot of listings here that are just in draft status. And then, you know, Jungle Scout tells you the quality of it. So this is like a fair listing, but this one could use some improvement. I can remember which date I originally created this listing and then the last time I edited it. So if we wanted to create one from scratch, I could click this button and I have 3 options here. The first one is to just draft a listing completely from scratch. If I wanted to optimize an existing product, like let's say that some people watching this video have already been selling on Amazon, but they're new to Jungle Scout. If you have active products on Amazon and you connect your accounts, you can just pull in the copy of your listing to our tool. And then that way you don't have to like type everything in manually and you can already get a little analysis for the quality of your listing. Or if you just wanted to do an analysis of an existing product on Amazon, like one of your competitors, you could just plug in a specific ASIN and then we would pull in the copy to our tool and you would be able to analyze it. I'm just going to go with the draft a listing here so that we can see how this would work from the very beginning. So if we chose our cat toys list, that means that I'm going to pull in all of those 600 something keywords from our cat toys list into the tool. If I hadn't done the research in Keyword Scout yet, I could still manually create a list here, but I don't recommend that. It's always better to do the research using Keyword Scout, create your list, and then just import it to the tool. When I click apply, this will then import that list of keywords and it will give me the chance to refine it a little bit. So I will often remove duplicates because you don't benefit from including a keyword more than once in your listing. It wastes valuable space that you could use for another relevant keyword. I don't usually bother with stuff like lowercase or whatever, but I do like to maintain phrases because if I don't click this box, it's just going to break all of these keyword phrases into each individual word. So I do maintain phrases. English speakers don't usually need to worry about special characters, but if you're selling in a market where there's diacritic marks, you might want to exclude those in case they cause any issues with the searches. So I'll click process and now it applies those rules to it. And I can sort it by alphabetical order. I can do it by the length of the keyword phrase or the search volume, which is represented by these numbers in gray right here. If I turn this the other way around, now it starts out with the highest search volume, which is cat food. So now that I've got my refined list, I've applied it to the listing builder. And now I'm down here in the actual content creator where I have all of the words over here on the left-hand side. I have the phrases with the long tail keywords over here. And then you can see I've got the box for my title and then each one of those feature bullet points I showed you, the product description. And then if you do have brand registry, you should click this box to let us know that you have A+ content as well. One other thing I want to point out is that there's also a box for what we call backend search terms. So if you want to include a really relevant keyword, or maybe here in the United States where there's a lot of Spanish speakers who are searching the Amazon.com website, they might have plugged in a Spanish keyword that's relevant to your product, even though your listing is in English, and you don't want the Spanish term or the other keywords to appear in the listing, but you still want Amazon to pick up on it to show people the product, you can put those in right here. So as a little, you know, to show you how this works, if I start putting in these keywords like cat it and gatos and cat food and mascotas, I mean, these are actually, some of these are Spanish keywords, but you can see that it's showing me that I've used these specific words, and that way I can be sure that I did include the words I wanted to. I don't have to worry about repeating them and wasting space. And then you can see that this little needle was starting to move because I was including keywords. So like my product title only has 31 characters, and we recommend that you have at least 100 to 200 characters. We'll tell you how many of your features you've used. So if I put in something like Smarty Cat, and then if I put in Irundo, I think this is the brand name, now we can see that two of the features out of the minimum of five have been included. I'm just putting in keywords to show you how this changes. Obviously, you need to write a really good listing that will convince people to buy your product while you include these keyword phrases. But I love this tool because it really makes it easy to understand whether you're including good keywords or whether you've forgotten one or not. And then you can also click this preview button, and then we'll show you a little mock-up of what your listing would look like once you export it to Amazon. Because we're only focusing on the text portion of the listing creation, we don't allow you to upload your images in Jungle Scout. Once you write the listing, you can push it to your Amazon account. And then from there in Seller Central, you can put your photos in and any of the other relevant information that Amazon wants. But this way you can at least kind of see what it will look like for somebody. And if you want, you can save this as a draft to come back to later, or if you're ready, you can click the sync to Amazon button and it will push it